Hey guys, it's Roxanne from RoxanneLynch.com. Hey! I know this seems like kind of a really strange topic for me to be chatting about today, discussing the ideas of being, of why gratitude should basically be our default setting, okay? When gratitude is our default settings, there's some pretty magical things that start happening in our lives. And to be honest, I didn't really understand the power of gratitude. I didn't understand the power of positive affirmations. I didn't understand some of the things that I guess were kind of natural for me. But then as I'm growing within my self-development, as I'm growing and reading more books, all of a sudden I'm finding that this gratitude thing is a big, hairy deal, okay? And I didn't even know that I've actually been doing it for a while. So I want to share some ideas and some insights about what comes natural to me, but then also I want to give you some hands-on tips that you can begin implementing in small pieces of your day, so you know you're going to get more out of your day. Like it's kind of crazy, but I have discovered that, and the experts agree with me here, that what you focus on grows. Okay, where our focus goes, where our energy goes, that blossoms. And it can be a positive thing or it can be a negative thing of deciding where you're putting your focus and your energy. So I know for myself personally, when I approach a problem or a trial or tribulation, some pretty amazing things begin to happen. Okay. Okay, so you guys know that this is what I absolutely love to do. This is what gives me a lot of joy in my day, is knowing that, you know, I get to show up and I get to add ideas to empower and enlighten and, you know, add some sunshine to your guys' day, some extra goodness, so we can all have success within this beloved industry and profession. So you guys can get some more traction, some more momentum, and gratitude is my default setting. But what I'm going to share with you guys is applicable no matter where you are, no matter what your business is, okay? So what I've learned over the years, and because I've had a crazy childhood, and you guys know about some of that, is that I've discovered that gratitude raises the positive emotions of other people, okay? So, and this is really powerful within network marketing. This is really powerful within your team and your culture and your community, that gratitude and thankfulness raises positive emotions in other people, okay? And when you do that, when you add that positivity and emotions of other people within your team, within your connections, your conversations, your community, that empowers a bunch of other people, of them to be able to overcome their battles. It's like you get to give to them something that is innately natural within yourself, this gratitude and this thankfulness, and other women can grab a hold of that, soak it up, and it pushes them forward. It lifts them up. It will bring them off of their knees. It will bring them out into some positive actions and activities within life, within relationships, within our kids and our family, and also within our network marketing businesses, okay? So gratitude raises positive emotions in other people. That is so powerful, because God knows the world needs more sunshine, right? So if we have it, we should be giving it, okay? So, I mean, and we think about that. I mean, when you dig into Maslow's hierarchy of needs, and if you guys aren't familiar with that, after the video, go Google Maslow's hierarchy triangle, okay? Appreciation, recognition, all those kind of things are right there in that triangle of human need to be valued, to be loved, to be appreciated, to be able to nurture and support and uplift and guide other women. Recognition, that attagirl, that is a significant need within our lives. And within network marketing, we get to do a lot of that. Okay, we have the ability. Some people don't do it, but if you have gratitude and thankfulness in your heart, it just comes out of you naturally. And they know it's a natural thing and they feel it. They thrive on it. Like I said, gratitude raises the positive emotions of other people, so it can empower them so they can recover quicker over their struggles and their battles, and they're gonna get to what we call that sunny side of life, okay? So gratitude also for me personally, I know that it helps me focus on what I can do, okay? Not what I can't. Because hey, I have crappy days too, okay? I have crappy moments. I just prefer not to focus on the do-do. I really try to focus on what I can do, not the other stuff, okay? If I was to focus on what I can't do and let that fill up the space in my brain, like we know, as my dad used to say, nothing positive comes from a negative mindset. So for me, I know that I have trials and tribulations. I know my team sometimes has trials and tribulations and struggles and problems. And like the post that I made with baby Eliza yesterday morning, you know, when life gives us challenges, then we're allowed to do better, be better, take down notes. And I think having a heart full of gratitude and thankfulness, when I do come across a challenge, and I find gratitude in that because it gave me a learning experience. And that's really powerful. So if I'm thankful, going like, wow, you know, I could have done better there, Roxanne. You know, you could have had better planning, or you could have had more communication, or you could have done this better. In those experiences, instead of me dwelling on the negative, I wrote it down in my book. And now next time we do an event or we do something, I know I can do it better. And that will bring even more success to my team. But if I was focusing on the negative, I'm not as open to finding and discovering that lesson. Does that make some sense? So I seek to find gratitude and thankfulness in the challenges and in the struggles, because it will help me nail it down faster, better, bigger, okay? So, because it's really our challenges and our struggles that help us shape the people that we are here today, that we're tenacious, that we're curious, and we have this stick-to-itiveness, and we have this ability to somehow get up and try this again because of gratitude, because of thanks, okay? And I get more done in my day, right? We get more done in our day when we're filled with gratitude. If we're focusing on negativity, or if we're focusing on drama or the doo-doo, we don't seem to get as much done, okay? We don't. It's just a negative spiraling black hole of energy, okay? So when I'm filled with gratitude and thanks, I find my whole day flows better. And things seem to work out faster. So if I am having a challenge or I am having a struggle, I get through it faster. Does that make some sense, you guys? And I'm happier, okay? I'm just a way more happier person. But, you know, some people seem to think that, you know, I don't have bad moments and I don't have bad days. I do the very best I can with the situation I am, just like all of us, okay? So the tips I have for you guys to help bring more gratitude into your world, to bring more joy, to bring more happiness, is the very first tip is don't be picky. Appreciate everything, okay? Appreciate that your alarm clock went off this morning and I was able to wake up on time, have a quiet morning with myself before I went and grabbed dad, and then we went to the city. It was an 11-hour day, you know? It was 2.5 hours into the city and then driving around and around the city to different doctor's appointments and then driving home, okay? So don't be picky, appreciate everything, okay? So that's when we get to, you know, appreciate the coffee pot still works, okay? Appreciate that, you know, someone didn't drink all your creamer. Appreciate that the Jeep started this morning. Appreciate things. Don't be picky. Don't be fussy. Find more gratitude. It doesn't have to be saved for the big things in life. I mean, I am really grateful right now with some big things in my life. So find the gratitude and the lessons and the learnings within your challenges. That is so, so powerful. Practice keeping like a gratitude journal. Like I have another little one, it's right here. And this is what I write my thankfulnesses in, okay? I wake up in the morning and I write down a few things that I'm thankful for. And you know, when I go to sleep at night, you know, and you know, I'm not a big churchy person, but I still say my prayers. I still go to bed, I say thank you for getting me home safe today. Thank you for no mooses jumping out in front of my vehicle. Thank you for the Jeep running well, and you know, or thank you for no one crashing into me at a yield sign. You know, all these things to be full of gratitude and excitement really makes and drills those ideas, the smallest little things, in a better way. Okay, so those are some of the ideas I wanted to give you guys today. Like I said, I come home, I was just overwhelmed with thankfulness and gratitude, and I thought, why not share some tips and ideas and solutions to what I call the sunny side of life. So you girls and guys have a fabulous evening. Bye guys.